dig a grave right under their noses. Their egos wouldn't let them think that.
It's a laugh-a-minute rags-to-riches farce that centers around a couple of second-rate actors longing to quit the biz to spend more time with each other.
We'll take it up to the hole once the hole's finished.
They're kind of fed up with the theater life and being away from each other. And Cindy gets the great idea that they could be these self-help gurus. So they take it on the road, and in 7 years, they become self-help gurus, multimillionaires.
The husband comes in one night from going to a movie and finds Cindy, my character, in a tryst with the gardener, who ends up being dead.
And that maybe you know something that I don't know.
The police come, and yeah, trouble ensues.
Written by Canadian playwright Norm Foster and brought to life by the Kamloops Players, self-help is fast-paced and funny, a chance for the small cast to let loose and have some fun with their characters.
For there to be harmony, two people must be singing.
Greg Duick plays Jeremy Cash.
I'm here as a guest of Mr. Vecchio.
Well, you can tell he has a good fashion sense right off the bat.
A nosy newspaper reporter looking for answers.
He knows that there's something not quite right with this self-help business that the rest of the world is falling under the spell of. So he's there to uncover what he can to find out the truth about what's really going on here.
Playing one half of the self-help empire is Jenny Lee Fraser in the role of Cindy Savage.
It really gives you an opportunity to be silly. Life is so serious, but once you walk into any theater group, the seriousness, it's second fiddle to the goofiness that goes on, and it really gives you a chance to relax and just explore different aspects of characters.
You're Helen Cindy Savage?
I'm Cindy, yes.
The self-help experts.
It's really therapeutic as well. Like there's not one character that I've ever played in theater that hasn't healed a broken part of me.
That's not fair. I've already explained what happened and why it happened.
All right. Never mind.
It's that healing, joyful aspect of community theater that keeps these actors coming back and inspires some to realize new passions.
And what time was that?
It was on my bucket list. I played in a number of stage bands. I was sang jazz for quite a long time, but I'd always wanted to act. And as I got towards retirement, I thought, you know, I think I have the time to do that. Even a rehearsal night like tonight, I'm just having fun. If it went no further than that, I would not feel I'd wasted my time, because you're meeting great people, wonderful personalities, a lot of good sense of humor, and you're using your mind.
No, ma'am. Mrs. Largent crossed the way, blew the whistle on him.
Now working hard to put the finishing touches on the show, the cast hopes the audience will find themselves using their minds as well, as self-help asks the question, is the grass really greener on the other side of the fence?
No, they'll want to see the art.
At the heart of it, it's about relationships, because Hal and Cindy are very much in love when they're these second-rate actors, acting on the outskirts of Flin Flon, Manitoba, and little... one horse theaters kind of thing. Very much in love, very happy, and then suddenly they're overnight successes, millions of dollars, and their relationship falls apart.
The show runs at 8 p.m. on April 24th, 25th, 30th, May 1st, and May 2nd, with a special 1 p.m. matinee on April 26th. For more information, you can find them online at www.kamloopsplayers.com. For Shaw TV in Kamloops, I'm Sam Numpson.